Hi friends, based on previous topic, we are going to give some string methods. Okay, so Python has a set of built-in methods that you can use on strings. Okay, in a previous video, we discussed uppercase, lowercase, like that you can take. What are the various types of string methods like this? In this case, here, first one is capitalize of something. What is the role of this capitalize? Converts the first character to uppercase. Okay. Next, second one is case fold. Convert string into lowercase. Third, center one is returns a centered string. Next, counter. What is the role of counter? Returns the number of times a specified value occur in a string. That is usually used for count purpose. Okay. Next one is encode. Returns an encoded version of the string. Okay. Ends with, that is return true if the string ends with the specified value. At this moment, we prefer ends with. Next one is expand tabs. Okay, set the tab size of the string. You can change from 4 tabs, 5 tabs, 6 tabs, like that you can change. Okay, next one is find. So that is searches the string for a specified value and returns the position of where the data available, like that you where you found, like that. Next one is format. Okay, formats specified values in a string. Generally, we can't add string and numbers in a single line. With the help of format, you can add the numbers in a string. Next one is index. So, searches the string for a specified value and returns the position of where found. That is the importance of this index here. Next one is alnum, that returns true if all characters in the string are alphanumeric. That is al for alpha, num for numeric, alphanumeric. Okay. Next one is here is alpha weight, that is returns true if all characters in the string are in the alphabet. Next one is decimal, returns true if all characters in the string are decimals. The type of expression purpose we prefer, this is the example this. Okay. Next one is digit, what is the returns true if all characters in the strings are digit. You have to check, are you getting all digits or not. The type of purpose we prefer this. Is identifier. Okay, what is the meaning of this identifier? Returns true if you will get that print so and so value, that you will get true if the string is an identifier or not, like that. Okay. Is lower. Third, next one is, okay, returns true if all characters in the string are lower cases. Okay, simply you are checking that if is like that. You have to check particular lower case is available or particular identifier available or is particular digit is available or not, particular decimal value available or not, alphabetic value or not, alphanumeric value or not, like that you can check the all samples here. Okay, is numeric. Okay, returns true if all characters in the string are numeric here. Is printable, returns true if all characters in the string are printable, like that you can take. Next, is space, returns true if all characters in the string are white spaces, like that. Next, is title, returns true if the string follows the rules of a title or. Is upper, returns true if all characters in the string are uppercase or not. Next, join. Okay, join the elements of an iterable to the end of the string. Next one is just, sorry, this one is L gest. That is returns a left justified version of the string. L for left, just for justified this. Next one is lower. Convert the string into lower case. In previous topic we discussed that. Okay. Next one is L strip. Returns a left trim. Left trim version of the string. Next one is make trans. Return a translation table to be used in translations. That is important of this. Next, partition. Return returns a tuple where the string is parted into three parts, like that you can take. And next, replace. Replace means returns a string where a specified value is replaced with a specified value. You can change, for example, you have to replace, already we have a case K letter, that is replaced by L, like that you can take. Okay. Next one is R form. Fine. So that is searches the string for a specified values and returns the last position of was found, like that. Next one is R index. That is searches the string for a specified values and returns the last position was found. That is actually R gest. Returns a right justification, justified version of the string. You know, previous condition we are having this L gest. This one is R gest. Next one is R partition. R partition returns a tuple where the string is parted into three parts. R split. That is split the string at the specified separator and returns a list. Okay, R strip. That is returns a right trim version of the string. Next one is split. Okay. Split the strings at the specified separator and returns a list. Next one is split lines. Split lines. So that is splits the string at the line breaks and returns a list. Next starts with. Returns true if the string starts with the specified value. You have to check a particular string is starts with capital A, capital B, small b, like that you can check. And one is strip. Okay. Returns a trimmed version of the strip. And swipe case. So that is a swipes the cases, lower cases become upper case and vice versa, like that. Okay. You know, need to title. Okay. Convert the first character of each word to upper case. Translate, return a translated string. Upper converts a string into upper case. Z fill, fill the string with a specified number of zero values at the beginning.